Trailer here, and today we are doing the finale, the season finale of Paper Jam Season 1. And in this episode, we have Agent Nevada, aka me, versus Lance. Let's start off with Lance. Lance is an OC skeleton created after Toby Fox's Sans. Lance is basically overpowered Sans, and he can defeat, like, 999,000 demons at once. You might be asking how. Well, he summons a bunch of bones, and this is just one attack, technically. So he killed all of those in one attack. Now, another thing you might be wondering is, how did he get his power? Right now, it's unknown. So basically, whenever you see Lance, you must be scared. He has cheese-powered bones, he has cheesy blasters, psychokinesis, teleportation, flight, super jump. He has many moves. And also, he's pretty powerful. So yeah, Lance is a very powerful person. You can withstand very powerful things. Let's move on to Agent Nevada, aka me. Agent Nevada is a freelancer. He's basically Dreadlord, but as a freelancer. Now you might be wondering, what? He's a freelancer? What does that mean? It basically means that he's powerful and he's way more stronger than a bunch of irregular stuff. So usually, well, Agent Nevada is extremely powerful. He has his speed. He has speed. He has strength. He has durability. He has stamina. He has defense. He has way more stuff than that, though. He has all the guns in Halo and all the guns in COD. Now, you might be wondering, how is that possible if he's in Halo and in COD? Well, he doesn't really have much weapons in COD, but he has all the weapons in Halo, including the Magnum pistol, the energy sword, the gravity hammer, the dual plasma pistols, and many more. Now, in this, he also has a rocket launcher. But yet, Agent Nevada doesn't stop there. Not only does he have that, his speed can easily match those of a freelancer's speed, including his AI, which lets him track where a land is. And not only that, but yet he has way more. He has suit advances, which means he can make his suit turn to a different color. He can activate some super speed. But yet, he's not really as open-minded. He's still smart, but not as open-minded. He doesn't have much to... and he's not a good strategist either. Anyway, that's these two characters. Let's see, who would win in a battle to the death? Oh yeah, also, since both of these characters need prep time, there is no prep time. Let the battle begin.
Answers. Alright, geez, my name's Lance.
It's none of your business. Now get out of my way. Whoa, whoa, whoa. No. Not yet. Very, very not yet. What? Whoa. That was close. Hey, what are you doing? Getting out the way of that. Suit yourself. Now explain or else I'll beat it out of you. Hey, whoa, I'm just here. I'm just here to stop you. Intense. Now, the reason why Agent Nevada won instead of Lance was because his armor can take up to tons of force. When I say that, I mean a ton of force. Now, he can lift 40 tons, but that's as much as he can lift. And also, what the? Whatever, never mind. Anyway, also, prep time wasn't in this battle, so you might be wondering how did Agent Nevada win? Well, it's actually pretty simple because he always carries guns around. But of course, he didn't have his rocket launcher around. This battle could have ended easily, and would have just wiped Sans off the earth. Except Lans. Wait, I said Sans. Sorry, I mean Lans. Is more defensive than that. He can take up to a bunch of power. inflicted on him. But of course, another thing he can do is take up to a ton more force. Now, guys, this was the season finale. Hopefully, y'all enjoyed this season. And goodbye.
Way to go, this is one of the best moments that we've done. Because I want to give a shout out to the first time. I love this season. I love this fight. Great job. And I told you that I'm going to now, guys. Let's go.